stationary quickly multiplied. And my favorite time to go shopping was for school supplies. I had Pentex and Vicks, Trapper Keepers and Meads, and felt no need to try out for the football team. I go to games with my friends, hiding markers in my sneakers, and when no one was looking, write graffiti on the bleachers. I found structure in hip hop, it calmed me, relaxed me, became one of the few things in life that could make me happy. And through it, I use rhymes to convey my thoughts, and they think twice about the sacrifices hobby would cost. I was a writer, lunchroom table prize fighter, dope rhyme reciter, a cipher circle igniter. And in spite of the fact that when I started I got laughed at, I cared less about what people had to say because I had rap. And would I do it all over again? Fresh out of school and I'm still writing. Hooked up with producers that gave me beats to enlighten. Exciting, no longer a hobby, it's a passion. Everything I did revolved around hip-hop and rapping. I got a job so I could buy beats and instrumentals, made tapes with my crew to pay dues, earning credentials. There was nothing you could say to separate me from my music. Confrontations with my girlfriend to the point where she would lose it and get upset that doing songs was all I was concerned with, and couldn't understand that without that I had no purpose. So that led to the sacrifice of my relationship, and I loved her but hated that my music made her sick. Oh no, from here, where am I supposed to go? Trying to score a decent future, but I can't approach the goal. Even though I might never see the picture as a whole, I never think I made a bad decision following my soul. And yo, job and proper education, hooked up with temperamental in search of my destination. Out of desperation and a struggle for good music, started Gray Matter to a hip-hop's dopest pursuers, cause it's hopeless to do this if you don't follow tradition. To be only about money's not our motto or mission. Don't get it twisted, cause don't no one wanna be broke, but I'd rather have your respect than have you call me a joke. So I'm bottling all these hopes up and keep them inside of me, but wondering what could happen really beats the shit out of me. I never doubted the only reason I'd ever make it is that I obviously believe it and keep it sacred. And there is not even a reason for me to change it. Believe me, I wouldn't change it even if I couldn't take it, cause rules is rules and life is life, and we done struggled too long to do wrong instead of right. And what's right for us is to keep it alive. This is our music, struggled all our lives to keep it right. And at night, shit, we ain't go to clubs, we went to work. Y'all needed to get weeded, all I needed was that verse, and all I needed was that verse to keep me from being hurt. But even when it would hurt, that'd be the reason it would work. So when the pain came, I tried to keep it on freeze. Y'all had cars and keys, we had MPs, and that sucked, seeing y'all with new clothes and kicks on, when I was busy coming up with new flows to rip songs, do shows to get on, different beats to spit on. I look for samples, y'all look for new hoes to hit on. I mean, I went to parties but mainly for open mics, getting cold as ice when y'all was outside provoking fights. We were serious ever since 88, y'all liked hip hop, but we were performing and making tapes, and that's real. We paid dues and put work in, and even after all of that, there's one thing that is for certain: I wouldn't change my past or anything in my life. I'd do it all again the same way without thinking twice. In fact, I'd pay more dues, I'd make more tapes. See, I'd do more songs, I'd break more dates. I'd spend less time talking and more time listening, more time creating, thinking and envisioning how life would be if only given a chance to put this craft to work I've worked so hard to enhance. But see, if given a chance, no second guessing or stressing, I'd do it all over again. No question.